Pick your Bible, stand with me for the reading of the word as it is our custom here. Luke chapter 22, verse 64. Just one verse and we have our seat. Luke chapter 22, verse 64. Are we there? Luke, as you look into the book of Luke, men will look into your life. Shall we read all together? One, two, go. And when they had blindfolded him, they struck him on the face and asked him, say, prophesy, who is it that smote thee? Let's read it one more time. And when they had blindfolded him, they struck him on the face and asked him, saying, prophesy, who is it that smote thee? May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Sit down on your enemy's head balandociously. Somebody shout fire. Are you ready? Our anchor scripture is taken from the book of Luke, chapter 22, verse 64. And when they had blindfolded him, they struck him on the face. And they ask him, saying, prophesy, who is it that smote thee? My topic today is, oh Lord, open my eyes. Tell your neighbor, oh Lord, open my eyes. I did not hear you well. Say it well. May the Lord open your eyes to see the person behind your problem. You didn't hear me well. May the Lord open your eyes to know the reason why you are like this. Now hear this. Some of you, you walk like elephant. You reap like ant, but you don't know why it is like that. You have stayed for 10 years, no baby. Something is behind this problem. You have aspired to occupy your desired position, but no way out. People that you are better. Get it, but you don't get it. Something is behind it. People make promises to you and they fail. You think it's ordinary. Something is behind it. Beautiful lady, figure 8, not married, 35, 40, 45, and yet you think it's normal. May God open your eyes to see who is behind the catastrophe around your life. Oh Lord, open my eyes. Oh Lord, open my eyes. Brethren, darkness is the greatest enemy of God.
In Genesis chapter 1.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. In verse 2, there was gross darkness upon the surface of the earth. And the Bible said, the earth was without form and there was darkness upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was moving. Before God continued creation, the next thing God did was that, let there be light. Nothing happened in darkness. Nothing happened in darkness. When your eyes are closed, opportunity will pass you. When your eyes are closed, blessing will pass you. When your eyes are closed, favor will pass you. When your eyes are closed, glory will pass you. And God saw the efficacy. God saw the importance of light. What God did was that God said, let there be light. God created the light before any other thing was created. Why? Because in darkness, powers of this world prevail. Can I say this to you? I don't know how long witchcraft has blindfolded you, but after today, they will let you be. I did not hear the amen well. I don't know how long they have closed you from seeing your helper. Some of you are close to your wife, but you cannot know because your eyes are blind. The Bible speaking in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 18, that the eyes of your understanding may be enlightened. He said, the eyes of your understanding may be enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling and what is the riches of glory of his inheritance in the saints. Can I pray for you today? May your eyes of understanding be open. Whatever is closed, I command them to be open. When your eyes are not open, you can never get anything. Hear this. Throughout the Bible, you will never see a blind woman but a blind man. Because when the man is blind, every other thing is blind. And Jesus met a particular man in the book of Mark chapter 8 verse 23. The man was blind, and he took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the town. And when he had spit on his eyes, he put his hand upon him. He asked him if he saw aught. Other scripture says he led the blind man out of his village. Some of you, the witches that is fighting you is in your village. They have blinded you that nobody can see you in Abuja. You went to America, nobody can see you. You went everywhere, nobody can see you. Hear this. Jesus is omniscience. He would have prayed for that man in the village. You know what he did? Come, my brother. He took the blind man by the hands and led him out of his village. Your problem is in your village. Oguidile Baba, Oguidile Ya, powers from your father's house, powers from your mother's side, powers from your wife's side. And Jesus led the man out of the village. After he led the man out of the village, he took saliva, his spat. This is the only miracle that look that has what I call a prophetic phenomenon. He spat on the eyes of the blind man, and after that, lay hands and prayed for the blind man. Then he now say, what can you see? Stay here. Put the next verse. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking. What happened is that it was not a mistake. Jesus wanted him to see the witches that are behind his blindness. So when the man's eyes open, when the man's eyes open, he saw powers of darkness that blindfolded him. They were like trees represent ancestral powers, ancient powers. They were walking on earth. Jesus was trying to tell the man, these are the powers from your village, that evil Iroko tree where they buried your star, that evil Iroko tree where they buried your glory, that evil Iroko tree where they buried your destiny, that evil Iroko tree where they buried your placenta, that evil Iroko tree where they buried your name. Today, wherever they are, they die by fire. I say, they die by fire. Some of you can never be rich until Jesus carry you away from your family. Some of you can never marry until you come out of your village. Some of you can never be wealthy until you separate from that your friend. Jesus brought me here to tell you, I pull you by the hand and take you away. Take it. Somebody shout fire. Shout fire. Where did they tide my glory? Where did they tide my blessing? Today, I pull you out of the village. I pull you out of the village. Wherever they tide you, wherever they tide your glory, wherever they tide your destiny, I am here like a Niger Delta 21st century army. Stay with me. I'm talking to somebody. Jesus said, you, this blind man, you don't know why you are blind. If you know why you are blind, as Jesus was about to take him, he saw that the man was living in the midst of witches. He said, no, I can't pray for you here, because if I pray for you here, before I take two steps, they will blind you back again. That is why you get rich today and tomorrow you go down. You rise up, you go down, because I want it on share. They are around you. Kokoro don't care for it, dear follower. I prophesy that person troubling your life today, I separate you. Hey! Somebody shot fire. Shot fire, yeah, yeah.
Hey.
Look at the next verse. And after he has put his hand again upon his eyes, he made him look up, and he was restored and saw every man clearly. May you see clearly. Did not say, hey, I now know the people behind me. Hey, Mama Mulika Momari. Hey, this is my grandfather. So he's the one behind the problem. Hey, this is my wife. He now saw clearly. I prophesy. Oh Lord, open my eyes. Oh Lord, open my eyes. Who is behind my problem? Who is behind my trouble? God, open my eyes to know them. Sit down. Sit down. Look at the next verse. He said, and he sent him away to his house, saying, neither go into the town, nor tell it to any in the town. Do you think Jesus does not have power to protect him? Is he not omniscient? He said, look, don't go back to that village again. Don't even tell anybody that your eyes are open. Don't tell them they want to give you contract. Don't tell them they want to give you appointment later. That friend is the problem. That friend, unfriendly enemy, familiar spirit from my family. Jesus said, don't go back to them. They are the reason why you are false blind. Today, after your eyes are open, you will not go back to your captives.
You will not go back to your tormentors.
Stay with me. Stay with me.
2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. He said, in whom the God of this world has blinded their mind of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. There is a God of this world that have blinded your eyes, your mind, that you see but you cannot see. There are people looking and not seeing. They are looking at your direction. They can't see opportunity. They can't see blessing. They can't see favor. They can't see glory. Today, I prophesy, may you see opportunity. I did not hear the amen well. May you see opportunity. May you see opportunity. Three dimensions of witchcraft operation. There are three ways witches operate. And let me tell you the three ways. Leave Luke chapter 22, verse 64 there. Three ways witches operate. Number one, when they have blindfolded him. Number one, dimension of witchcraft operation, they blindfold you. Witches cannot operate until they close your eyes. Witches cannot operate until they close your eyes. They are not powerful. They will blindfold you. They will cover your eyes. Because if your eyes is covered, you will not know who is fighting you. Brethren, a snake is not powerful. It is only powerful when you are blindfolded to know the area where the snake is hiding around your house. So you know why? The snake strike you in your ignorance and begin to run. There are enemies that are around you, and the reason why they are powerful is because your eyes are blind. You cannot recognize them. Number one way witches operate is to blindfold. When a man is blind, he's finished. Doesn't know his left from his right. Anything comes. He dine with his enemy. He fly aeroplane with his enemy. He wants to go for an appointment. He calls his enemy and tell them, I am going for appointment. You give everybody the name of your children. You give them your children placenta to help you bury. The reason is because you are blind. Witches operate in darkness, and blindness is darkness, and darkness is ignorance. And the Bible says we should not be ignorant of the devices of the enemy. The reason is because when you are ignorant, witches become superpowered. You know why? They will never allow you to come to a church where the prophet can see. Because they know if they see, that is the end of the problem. Who blindfolded me? Who covered my eye? Who covered my eye? Who covered my eye? Who covered my glory? Who covered my favor? Who covered my blessing? Where are you today? Catch fire! Catch fire! Catch fire! Catch fire! Number two, leave that scripture there. Let me show you. Three dimension of witchcraft operation. They struck him on the face. Number two operation is that. Stroke there. Witchcraft. After they blind you, they strike you. Witches can never fight you in daylight. They fight you in darkness. because they will never allow you to know who they are. What is the meaning of occultism, secret mystery? What is hidden? Cultic people do not operate under broad light. They operate in secrecy. Who strike me? Who strike me? Hear this. Do you know why they blindfolded you? Because if your eyes are open, if somebody wants to touch you, you will defend. But because your eyes are blinded, they touch you from the back and you never know who touched you.
When they wanted to kill him, he received him to the field.
In the book of Genesis, I think chapter 3 or 4, the Bible says, Cain struck his brother and slew him to death. The way they do it, they deceive you. Deception is another methodology to blindfold you. And when they want to strike you, they strike you without remedy. I don't know where they have touched you. I don't know whether it's in your business. I don't know whether it's in your political career. I don't know whether it is in your head. I don't know whether it's in your ministry. Who strike me? Who touch me? Where did they touch you? Did they strike your womb? That's why you don't have baby. Who touch me? Did they touch your political career? Where did they touch? Today, they shall catch fire. I'm not hearing the amen well. They shall catch fire.
They wanted to strike you,
sir. Ma, they didn't touch you by the back. They touch you by the face. And the face from neck upward. You know why? They touch your eyes so that you can't see opportunity. They touch your mouth because all the five senses are here. They touch your ear so that you will not hear when storm and battle is coming. They block your ear so that you cannot hear word of prophecy. They touch your mouth so that you cannot shout for help. They have touched all your five senses and blocked everything so that you can't think straight. You can't perceive that there is an enemy close to you. You cannot smell a rat. You cannot perceive. You cannot speak. You cannot hear. They have killed everything that you should have been able to use to detect them. Strike me. Who strike me? Who strike me? Where did you touch me? Do you know why they blindfolded you? They don't want you to know how they did it to touch you. Because if you know how they did it to touch you, you will know how to defend yourself in the first place so that they don't touch you. And if you know where they touch you, you can know how to take a first aid treatment quickly. But you do not even know where they touch you. And you do not even know who touch you.
Number three.
Number three. And ask him. What does that mean? Witchcraft operate so that your life can be a question mark. They create a question mark around your life. After they blindfold you, they strike you, then they begin to show you as a question mark. You say you are born again, and yet for 10 years, no baby. You said you are born again. You are a preacher. Your church is not growing. You said you are born again. You cannot get the appointment. You say you are born again. You are closer to the president, and there is no help. They create a question mark. Lord, what kind of question mark have they created on my life? My life is not a question mark. My life is an answer. Today, enough of that reproach. Every question mark they have created, anytime people see you, Odengbawe, Odengbadura, Ibololorewa, they are asking, where is your God? They have created a question mark. Like Anna, they have created a question mark. I don't know the question mark. Today, enough is enough. It shall catch fire. I did not hear the amen well.
They make you to even doubt God. You begin to ask God,
why?
But then see,
I am worshiping you. Why did my wife die? Why did my son die? It is witchcraft. They want you to ask God why. They blindfold you. They strike you. Then they now make your life a question mark. Today, every unanswered question in your life shall be answered. Shall be answered. Every unanswered question. The question. They say you pay tight. They say you pray. But yet, you cannot get the job. You cannot get the appointment. They say you pray. You fast. And yet, there is no husband. You are 35. You are 45. They blindfolded you. They strike you. After they struck you, they now ask you, prophesy. Slap you. Hey, they are saying, where is your God? Today, the lion of the tribe of Judah shall show up for you. Sound that amen like thunder.
Sit down. Stay with me. 10 years of my life in the city of Ibadan. I live in Ojuri Akobo. Did ministry for 10 years. Highly anointed. Crippled walk. Blind see. Dead body come back to life. But I could not pay house rent of 3,000 naira. Is it 3,000? No. For 1 year it was 6,000. For 6,000 naira for 1 year. I couldn't pay the house rent. I became a question mark. My landlord asked me, the church will bash and say, oh, yeah, the church in there. I became a question mark. One day, my own mother called me to the bedroom and said, she called me by my Muslim name. She said, Kazim. That was after knowing me for Joshua for years, after she had been converted. She now called me Kazim. Shebi o shema ba loleleyi. O den gbe Bible yi o den so fun gbogbo wa ka tele e. Ounje wo ri je. Food you do not have. We are following you up and down. You say we should be born again. Now we are not born again. Your suffering is high. You come back home to eat at home. She now started crying. Ha! Ki yo bi omo meje ko ma ri kokon ninu won to ni lari. My mother wept before me. Then I left her and I cried on the way. And I say, Lord, what a question mark. This is a slap to you. He did not bring me out of darkness into light to take me back again. Today, that question mark is over. My head, Kalalalabada, Zebalia,
Le para, je para la labado. I prophesy that question mark is over. Le para la ba, je para. That question mark is over. Hey, hey. Impractusible. That question mark from my father's house, from my mother's side. Hey, Leba, today it is over. Asking question, where is your God? After the end of this service, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nisi, Allah Kwanlato Sole Ayero, Kiniwu Eya Judah, he will show up to show himself. Somebody shot fire. Sit down. Can I get five of the protocols? Come here. Five of you, come quickly. Come to the altar here. Five, just five. Thank you, Jesus. Five, come. Line up here. Line up. Face me, just face me here. Face me direct. Line up. Yes. Yes. Five of you. Thank you. Are you married? You're married. Who among you is not married? You are not married. Okay, you come and stay here. You come here. Can I get any woman with any veil, is it hair tie that I can use just to tie somebody's face? Just veil. Okay, thank you. Thank you. That's good. Bring it. Come. Use it to tie his face. Tie it very well. Make sure it's not seen. Is that thing thick? Tight. Tight. Tie the face. Yes, the face. Go to his back and tie it well. Tie it well. Tie it. Don't worry, he's under tension. You are making him to be under tension. Help him, help him. I don't know, but after this service, something is about to happen. It's okay. Are you seeing?
No, sir.
Eh?
No, sir.
Are you sure you are not seeing?
Yes, sir.
Don't do boji boji bo joro. Hope you are not seeing.
No, sir.
You are not seeing. Thank you. Thank you. I want to show you something here now. Follow me and please write. I call it six things that happen when you are blindfolded. Six things that happen when you are blindfolded. The guy is blind. Number one, when you are blindfolded, you can't eat the fruit of your labor. Brother, can you see anything?
No, sir.
Look around. Look at your front. Can you see?
I can't see anything.
Eh?
No, sir.
Can you see?
No, sir.
Look around. Can you see?
No, sir.
Eh?
No, sir.
When you are blindfolded, watch me. The food is prepared, but you cannot see it. God appear and say, hey, my daughter, my son, I have prepared your food, but you can't see it. Can you see it? He can't see it. He can't see anything. Can you see? Brother, can you see?
No, sir.
Can you see anything?
No, sir.
When you are blindfolded, when witches blindfold you, they will not make you to see, to eat the fruit of your labor. Ah! You will walk and walk and walk. You will not see what you are working for. God has prepared the food. The food is before him. Brethren, the man is blinded by witchcraft. He could not see it. You are saying, God, you told me I am blessed. God said, yes, you are blessed. Look at the blessing. But you cannot see it. The problem is not that God has not made the provision, but when Jesus blindfolded your eyes, that you cannot know your helpers. Your helpers are before you, but you don't know them. You walk with your enemies and you run. You hate your helpers. You befriend your enemies and you hate your helpers.
Watch this.
Take your food.
Brother, take your food.
Use your hand.
Try.
That's what some of you are doing. Other house have blinded you. They have blinded you that you cannot see. Now,
I remove the veil.
Take your food. When your eyes is open, you can eat the fruit of your labor. You can now eat it. Take your life. Enjoy your life. You will eat the fruit of your labor. Let me keep this one here. Be eating your food. Eat it where. I prophesy. Today, I open your eyes to see where your opportunity is. I open your eyes to see where your problem is. I prophesy, wherever they have blocked you, wherever they have done against you, today I open your eyes.
Fine, let's go back number two.
Blindfold him again. Who gives this one to Dr. Nick? Are you sure that's it?
When you are blindfolded, hey, you shun in life. They will all fall in a ditch. I pity you if your prophet does not see. I pity you if your pastor does not see. I pity you if you are a pastor and you don't see. Because it is a catastrophe for you not to be a seen preacher or a seen prophet.
He is to become the president. He is to live here to America, but he lacks direction.
Not because there are no intuition for direction, but because he is blind, he don't know how to go. Now, watch this. If I want him to get to that door,
now it's time to get to the door.
Brother,
I want you to get to the door. Start walking. Walking, please guide me.
Start walking. You can see. Follow him, not to fall. You can see.
When you are blindfolded, when you are blindfolded, watch this. Wait. When you are blindfolded, you don't know the direction. Because your eyes are blind. The way to make it, you don't know. They have covered your eyes. That's why you are doing trial by error. Every way is a way to you because there is no instruction. Instruction is the highway to destiny construction. When you are blindfolded, you don't know the way. You don't know the way. When you are blindfolded, you don't know the way. Watch this. Stay here. Are you seeing?
No, no.
Okay. Number three. Are you following me? Somebody shout fire. When you are blindfolded, you don't know who to marry. Can I get four sisters from the choir? Come. Just come, four of you. Come. Don't worry. Don't stay. Oh, I wouldn't have done this. His brain, his mind is working. Don't worry. His mind is working.
Because his mind is behind.
Are you hearing me? Because as I say choir, he knows his choir. Because there's eyes in your mind. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. Please. Yes. Brother, go and look for your wife. Proverbs 18:22. He that findeth a wife, findeth a good thing. Findeth a good thing. Go and look for your wife. 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 Ah! Go and look for your wife.
He's looking for his wife.
Hey! You see?
He's looking for his wife.
He's looking for his wife. That is how some of you young men are looking for wife. Because witches are blind you. Witches are blind you. Witches are blind you. You see, he was looking. He almost touched a man.
He almost touched a man.
That's how you have gone to marry a man and not a wife. Because you are blinded. Who blind my eyes? Who blind my eyes? Who blind my eyes? When you are blind, you begin to go left and right. You can see him, he's going to look for his wife around the drum set and the musical instrument. I don't know who blind you. I don't know how they blind you. I don't know how they blind you. But today, I open your eyes. At where the wife is. These ones here are the true wife that is given to him by God. But look at where he's looking for wife. Some of you are to marry in Lagos. You went down to Italy to look for a wife. And they have italicized your destiny in Italy. Hey! You are 45, you are not married. Who blind your eyes? Who blind your eyes? Some of you, your wife is sitting next to you. But because you are in the same church, you say, I don't know. You are blinded. You are leaving your church, going to the village to look for Inembri, Imbrena, Insue. You can see. He's tired. He's tired. You don't even know. Ibonimowa. Ibonimotewa. That's how some men are. They have walked around. They go to a place now. They don't say, I think I am Brother Paul in the Bible. I'm not called to marry a wife. Who blind your eyes? Who blind? How did you do it to the extent that you not marry a witch? How did you do it, sister, to the extent that you marry a murderer? How did you do it, sister, to the extent that you marry a drunkard? Who blind your eyes? Your mother warned you, ma fe okuri oleni, but your eyes is blind. Hear this. If love is blind, marriage will open your eyes. I said, wait. If love is blind, marriage will open your eyes. There are women you marry. After you marry, you now know your eyes will be open. It's better for your eyes to be open before you marry.